G'day, Joey here. As you know, I like to look at albums from 50 years ago. And I just thought, as we approach the end of 1974, I'll dig out a few more records I own from that period, 1974, that is. We've got Rick Wakeman's Journey to the Center of the Earth. Rick Wakeman, obviously, a member of, at some point, or various times, a member of Yes, but also did many solo albums during the 70s. In fact, around this period, he did four or five consecutive albums that were massive albums. I recall they always had very long titles. So, and yeah, so Journey to the Center of the Earth. The one after, released after this one, that I also own is King Arthur and the Knights of the Round Table, I think it's called. What else we got? I just got a few. Yeah, oh, Supertramp, Crumb of the Century. So I love Supertramp's work from this period. A couple of big songs released from this record, Bloody Well Right, and of course Dreamer was a big hit. Both great songs. How about this one? This is from exactly 50 years ago, November 74 released. Queen, Sheer Heart Attack. This had the hit song Killer Queen. Queen had just started to make a name for themselves. I always thought this was their debut album. I don't think it is. I think it's their second album. But as I said, it's at this point where people are starting to take notice. So, I mean, this is a great record, by the way. Some fantastic tracks in here. Then they sort of mix up a bit of prog rock, a bit of glam rock, a bit of hard rock, and then a bit of just experimentation. And you know, they always love to throw in little jazzy ragtimey type little tunes or little show tunes. You know, they always do that in all their albums. But I really like this album. But the album I want to look at, which I don't own anymore. I did own the record back in the day, pretty close to when it was released, is this one by the mighty sweet Desolation Boulevard. And this is hands down the best album Sweet ever made. And I think even I've heard the members individually say something similar. Certainly right up there, but it's my favourite Sweet album. And this is the thing, and we're going to take a look at the opening track, the 16s, which is one of the all time great Sweet songs, I reckon. Don't think it was ever a single. And what I was about to say was that right through the 70s, Sweet had enjoyed enormous chart success with singles, had many huge hits, great songs too. Really, all the big hits they had, they're all still great songs, I reckon. But unlike a lot of the 70s bands, the ones we just looked at, they never focused as much on their albums as they did on their singles, and that's why I think this album is a standout, because it clearly is an album they put a lot of thought into. That it wasn't just a case of creating a record where they could dump a few singles on and fill it up with a bit of filler. This is a strong album all the way through. And the one big single it does have was not even a single at this point, and that is Fox on the Run. So the original version of Fox on the Run is on this album, but it is a lot different to the single that was released, I don't know, maybe 6 to 9 months after the release of this album. And they sort of, not necessarily redid it, but they clearly added extra tracks so that it sounds quite different to the original version. Also in this, well, as I said, the opening track, the 16, is a great number. The one that follows, Solid Gold Brass, that's a good number. Got a couple of They do a great cover of My Generation. In fact, indeed, it was on this album that I first heard of that song. And so I didn't realise it was a Who song till much, much later. Okay, as I said, Turn It Down. Let's have a look. Not Turn It Down. That is another song on the album. Well, we've got The 16s that opens this track. And I'm playing through my blues journey. I'm only using my video mic, not using any recording on this. So I haven't done any, tabs either, but with the intro, so I'm only going to look at the intro, the intro riff, very, very famous riff. And it's only using these four notes, yeah? Yeah, open D. Yeah, D, E, F sharp, G. Yep. Yeah. So there's a pretty close to the intro riff. It's possible he's doubling up on guitar, so there might be another Andy Scott. May have been recording at least one other guitar track that does it an octave. So we're using identical notes, but we're up here on this, starting the 7th fret, D note, G string. At the end of the bar or the following bar does a slide up. So that's sort of the opening riff. It's something like that, isn't it? A great aspect about this song, I mean, the great lyrics, but there's a great acoustic guitar in the song, and the Suite didn't commonly use acoustic guitars. They were very much about overdriven, riff-based songs. But this song is one of the, it's fair to say one of the rare occasions where there's an acoustic. Lady Starlight, another track on the album, has some clean rhythm guitar sounds. It probably has an acoustic in there, I can't recall exactly, or an acoustic-y type electric rhythm bit. But the 16s has an actual acoustic guitar sound, and it's really, really great sounding, and I just was checking out the chords the other day, a couple of days ago. So, yeah, the riff goes. Then, it's repeated roughly. And then you've got this nice acoustic guitar comes in at that point, playing sort of a D, or might even be a D5. And then the scene comes in on this F sharp major. Just slides up one half step to a G chord, yeah? Back to the F sharp major. Yeah? And then the overdriven guitars and the rest of the instrumentation comes in over the top of that as the song goes on. And then at some point, ends on this A, what is it? Jill and Johnny, now you've made it. Toot, but life. And then it goes on. As I said, great lyrics, great song. The song hangs together really, really nicely. Really well-constructed song. As I said, fantastic acoustic guitar played with the oven-driven guitars in between. Andy Scott plays lots of little fills right through the verses and chorus. And you got that, iconic intro. Oh, well, that's a quick look at the 16s from my favourite Suite album, Desolation Boulevard, released exactly 50 years ago. If you're not familiar with the album or indeed with this song, go and have a listen to it. Okay, thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.